All right, Change Space, welcome to another YouTube video. Playing some video games today. Today, of course, we're playing some NBA 2K20, but not for long with 2K21 right around the corner. Yeah, we got our My Team Dev update. You can find the update on My Team's Facebook page. We'll add a link to the page in the video description of this video if you want to check it out and read through it. Yeah, today's video, just our takes after giving it a read through. We are super anxious and ready for the release of the new NBA 2K21. Release date is September 4th, and that is the date we'll all begin building our dream teams, as they stated in the courtside report for My Team. Yeah, and 2K right out of the gate, reassuring the community that the transition between current and next gen for PlayStation and Xbox will be super smooth, almost seamless with the transition, meaning confirmed your entire collection and My Team progress as you work through the new 2K21 season will carry over if you make the move to a next gen console, whatever it may be, either Xbox or PS4. What that means is your entire card collection will move. That's good. Any evolution progress you've made with any cards. So for that card where you have to get say 1,000 steals or blocks to evolve, good news, that grind will continue on your next gen console. Also, your progress from any game modes, domination, triple threat offline, etc., will also all carry over. All your MT, virtual currency, tokens, that'll carry over too. So for you token hoarders and MT millionaires, your continued wealth, you will continue to thrive. It'll only work though across matching consoles. So for Xbox to Xbox Series X, and then for PS4 to PS5, does not mean if you're switching, say, from Xbox to PS5, you'll be out of luck, but that's not a big thing. Takeaway, though, means you'll be able to play 2K21 all season, uninterrupted, so no hitting a second reset if you're making the move to a next-gen console. Now, a side note, though, if you do plan on buying the Mamba Forever Edition, you will get a copy of the standard edition for 2K21 on the matching next-gen console. That's cool. That'll save you some cash. What's not cool, though, is the Mamba Forever Edition will set you back $100. Now, for what we can expect for My Team content, new for 2K21 are seasons and seasonal content. So we've got scheduled releases. That's a good thing. Be able to put these on your calendar. Now, seasons, they were a little vague, but their goal is to keep the game fresh, keep it exciting for the community. So they did hint at, like, say, new content, like a Spotlight Sim series is possible, maybe adding new features to the game and adding a new reward twist to chase. They did say seasons will be 6 weeks in length, where you will work to complete daily, weekly, and seasonal agenda goals, earning XP to raise your season level. Leveling up, you'll earn rewards. And when you reach the final level of the season, you will earn a grand prize reward, letting everyone know that the reward will be completely worth it, and revealing that a pink diamond Steph Curry right out of the gate will be the first ultimate grand prize reward. Looking at the season's reward screen, you will be earning a reward for each level, it looks like. Levels up to 40, earning tokens, a Hall of Fame badge pack, that's cool, and yeah, a pink diamond Steph Curry, a 96 overall, and liken the early look at the card art. So seasonal prizing updates to keep it fresh for us. They did say that new vault prizes will be added at every season for Triple Threat Offline, and that it'll be updated during the season as well. Triple Threat Offline, they explained the way it's going to work is that season wins will stop at 300 for season one, and you'll earn a, what they said is a darn good player reward card. Now you can continue to play and get the vault, so confirmed the vault is back. And then with every new season that's rolled out, you will get a ladder update to Triple Threat Offline. So they gave the example of adding another 150 wins to the ladder to earn the new player reward card. Yeah, pace those kids that got to 1,000 wins of Triple Threat Offline last season right out of the gate. Me, I was legit concerned for those kids that did that right away and for their mental health. This is a great idea, as their goal is to give out reward cards that'll have value to lineups, rewards that'll basically fit the current season within My Team. Yeah, better rewards to match your time and effort, your sweat equity, as they call it. Triple Threat Online, they did confirm that the ball drop reward boards are back, but now with faster drops. Yeah, we all dreaded this season the 5-drop reward boards, where they would take at the very least 5 minutes to complete, and that's not a joke. They did add up front a screen where you first enter Triple Threat Online that'll highlight the best prizes available on each tier of boards. So some transparency there, that is a good thing. Let you know what you're playing for. This, for the first time ever, dynamic domination seasonal updates. Yeah, adding new tiers to domination. This is something that the community has been asking for many years, and that's for domination updates throughout the season versus getting it all up front right out of the gate. Now, it won't be an every season thing, they did confirm that, but they did confirm that they will be adding a few new tiers to domination over the course of the NBA 2K21 season. Yeah, so giving domination some late season relevance, and again, earning better updated and current rewards reward cards to match your time and effort for playing the game all season long versus rushing through Dom that first week of its release, getting player cards that are more relevant to the current season that you're playing. Now, they did say new cards are going to be added every season to the token reward market, so we now know exactly when to expect a token market update. That is a great thing. My Team Unlimited. This is a brand new game mode that we're really excited about. Yeah, it's a 5v5 online multiplayer mode where you're chasing these championship rings. Now, it's only available on the weekend, so Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And each weekend, they'll announce new lineup restrictions for the game mode. They gave a couple examples of where you could only use players that are under the age of 23, a tier restrict where you could only use, say, a Ruby card or lower. But the goal here is to keep lineups fresh. Yeah, use more cards in your collection, and then to give us special weekend events that'll draw us to the game and want to play it more. It's also fantastic because lower tier cards are now going to have increased value this season. Cards like, say, for example, a Ruby Thon Maker or a Sapphire Jonathan Isaac could potentially have a ton of value, either in your collection or to flip in the 2K auction house, which we love. Now, every weekend, chasing after these championship rings, they'll be up for grabs, but how do you get them? With every online win, you get a reward. Now, you can either choose to keep the reward or trade it in for a mystery prize, which could be better or worse, or it could be a championship ring. Collect all the rings at the end of the season. You trade them in for a player reward card. This should be interesting. A six-week season for a player reward card that doesn't have the community's interest could be a bust, or it could be a really good player reward card. For example, this Pink Diamond Ralph Sampson could be a really good player reward card. That is, if they fix Ralph's tiny T-Rex arms. Hopefully that's corrected in 2K21. Now, My Team Limited will definitely add some fun to the auction house. Cards that are eligible to be in the weekend's limited events will have these little stickers on them where you'll be able to filter them to help you create your lineups. Really doubt the filter will be available in the auction house, but it will definitely add a new element to sniping and flipping cards, no question. Now, takeaways, 2K has finally listened and given us a My Team game mode that's new. We need variety and a 5v5 online game mode that'll make lineup creation more interesting and give us more variety to the game. In a game that should have more balance, give us some variety to lineup creation, be more challenging and fun. Definitely looking forward to this new game mode. Now, My Team Unlimited 2.0, this sounds like they've revisited the My Team Online format from 2K17 and earlier, where what they've done is they've put together 9 leagues. You'll need to play through each league or tier in order to get to that very top tier, like PlayNow Online, where you'll need to win a certain number of games in your current league before you can advance. Now, they did give a specific example for the first league, where you'll need to win 3 of your 12 games to advance. Now, if you win your first 3 games right away, you do not need to play your remaining 9 games. As you move up, though, to advance, you'll need more wins. And yes, you'll still need to go 12-0 in the Galaxy Opal tier to win the season's exclusive prize. That will continue to be super sweaty, so that's good news for the 12-0 grinding services, but they'll be able to continue to keep their shops open. I am more curious, though, about the matchmaking. If you're in the top Galaxy Opal tier, will you only get matched up against others in the Galaxy Opal tier? Or is there the possibility that you could be playing bums in the bottom tiers and go 12-0? They did say, though, that there's going to be an XP reward that can be earned, and the XP can be redeemed for rewards. Overall, I think this has promise, as it should bring more players to the game mode with the 9 specific leagues for 5v5. Our biggest question is, though, is the matchmaking. How will this play out? We want a game mode that ultimately brings more people to the game and enjoy the gameplay experience. We feel tiered matchmaking will do this, but again, we'll see how this plays out. Now, the exchange, this is new, a new market where you can turn in or exchange cards from your collection for some, quote, great prizes. You can earn new player reward cards. They did say that on the surface, some of these player reward cards may look average, but they could have future value to My Team Limited events. Maybe worth paying attention to those as they are introduced. Now, it's also a chance to turn in lower tier cards that don't have a lot of value for consumable items that do have value, like diamond contracts and diamond shoes. They did mention, too, that this season there's going to be a ton of new diamond shoes introduced. That's cool. Diamond shoes are a great way to customize your player cards. It's also a great item to flip in auction. Now, takeaways, absolutely, this is a good thing. The exchange cards in the past that had little or no value could now potentially have some increased value. And yeah, items like diamond contracts and shoes, these types of items will have value all season long. And also interesting because lower tier player cards will now have increased value this year with the new limited weekend events. The exchange market is something we'll be following closely. Badge customization. This is going to be new, where you'll be able to customize player cards to better fit your play style. Yeah, Hall of Fame badges, they said, are going to be rare and made available primarily from playing the game, which is good, but I really doubt this. They'll find a way to make them available for purchase in packs. They did also call out that badges are going to be limited based on a player's archetype and play style. So no limitless range on your bigs, but again, can see right through 2K here and them giving us glitched out of position badge dip cards that will go against a player's archetype, and they'll do it pretty quick. But Evos are back this season. That's a good thing. Evos are good fun and are now customizable, meaning you're going to have control now over your Evo cards and how they tier up. And they've introduced a new branching concept, and they used an example of Shaq, where at the start of the season, you're going to get to choose whether you you want to improve Shaq's rebounding or shot blocking. This is cool, making cards more unique to your playstyle and making your lineup more unique. Now, Ascension, this is new too, and kind of had us scratching our heads. They've described it as a new prizing mechanism that'll reward you for playing the game mode, My Team, but they didn't say how. Is it for just daily logins, or is it for playing different game modes and meeting different daily agenda goals? Whatever the mode is, cool with more rewards. Hedged a little, though, by looking at the screenshot of the Ascension reward board. Gave me flashbacks of the 2K17 Blacktop reward board with the technical fall cards and me getting Diamond Kevin McHale. So many times I stopped counting and never got the ultimate reward, that Pink Diamond Isaiah Thomas. Probably had over 1,500 games in two, which was not awesome. They did talk about some other things like the Idols Series Collection. This will replace this year's Prime Series Collection. It's going to be a mix of past and present players. And they did say that with the Idols Series packs right out of the gate in September, that we'll be getting a pullable Pink Diamond card. That is interesting. They did not say who it's going to be, but a chance of having a Pink Diamond in your lineup early will definitely create some auction house hype. And we're all about auction house hype. For each series, there'll be a collection reward, which is always interesting. And speaking of interesting, how about Dark Matter? Saying really nothing more than just be aware of it. It's out there. What it sounds like is we're getting a new ultimate tier of player card. We'll definitely watch for that. The holographic ball. I love the fireball this season. It was pricey to get, but they had a weekend promo this season that really helped me get it. Without it, it would have been almost impossible to get. They're saying the holographic ball is going to be just as challenging. I just want to know if the holographic ball is going to have some sort of cool vapor trail like the fireball had. That was cool. Now, they did give a reminder, too, to make sure you get your special My Team Moments Challenge done for 2K20. It's live until next week, Friday. They haven't revealed what's going to be in the pack. That's going to be waiting for you when you open 2K21 for the first time. They did hint that it's not going to be a player reward card, but that you're going to absolutely want this pack. I'm guessing it's probably going to be a diamond shoe or maybe one of these new Hall of Fame badges that you'll be able to apply to a card. We don't know. What we do know is that we're ready for 2K21. Let us know your thoughts about the dev update in the comments section below. What are you looking forward to? What are they missing? We were kind of hoping for a pack and playoffs this season, but didn't get it. But it still looks solid. Now, likes greatly appreciated as we get ready for the My Team 2K21 season. And subscribe if you're new to the channel. Only the best tips and tricks on how to play My Team, no money spent. For Party Pete, this is Space. We're out.